Today is an exciting day. You just woke up and you're still a little woozy from being asleep for so long. The destination of your journey is a great distance away from your home planet, so you spent most of the trip in an artificial slumber. And while you don't feel like you've been asleep for very long, your body is stiff from having been inactive for such a long time, and your thoughts are slower than you would like. It's not really a big deal, however. You still have a lot of time to regain your physical and mental strength. And even then, the main objective of your mission is quite simply to observe. That's why the windows of your vessel are so large, and the ship's ultra-zoom cameras are the very best your scientists could make, so you will get an excellent view of everything you will come across on your journey. You can already see the star, a yellow-white light in the distance. It seems a bit unassuming compared to blue supergiants or red hypergiants, but looks can be deceiving. Your windows come with automatic filters, so you won't be blinded by the light. This is a small star, but so close it shines brightly indeed. After extensive study, this star and its system of planets were chosen for a very special reason. Your ship's computer knows how to navigate on its own, so you have all the time to sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. Hey, what's that? Your computer has found something, and is now zooming in. Oh, you must have passed the star's sphere of influence quite some time ago. There's this dark, grayish-brown lump of mostly ice and rock. A comet. Way out here, it doesn't really look like anything special, but when its orbit takes it to approach its star, it will start to warm up and evaporate, and that gas and ice will form a spectacular tail. The ancients believed comets appearing in the sky to be portents of doom, but in reality, they're just leftovers of a star's formation process. Most of them sit on the outskirts of a star's sphere of influence, and they may take many lifetimes to complete one full orbit. The computer continuously images the comet as you pass it by, and makes an analysis of the object's size and composition. All in all, it's nothing more than a cold, small space rock. It's interesting enough in its own right, but you know much more amazing things lie ahead. As time passes, so do several more comets and other small rocky objects like asteroids, and slowly but surely their numbers seem to be increasing. This is good. It means you're quickly getting closer to some truly exciting stuff. Another noise, a bit louder, a bit more pressing, but no reason for alarm. The window screen shows you something that makes you sit up straight and pay attention. Could it be? It looks like you're approaching a very small planet dead on. It's tiny, but clearly spherical, and because you're coming up right behind it, it eclipses a star and... Is that... Does it have an atmosphere? It does. It's very thin, but it's clearly there. What an incredible view. Your ship zooms closely past the tiny planet, and you turn around so you can take a good look while you can. The surface of this planet is mostly icy white, with blotches of pale yellow and rusty brown. It's littered with craters and chasms, and you suspect this planet has been orbiting here at the outskirts of the system for an extremely long time. Hey, the planet has a companion! You almost missed it because you were so preoccupied. This companion planet is smaller and mostly gray, and its surface is rough and cratered as well. But you find there is a quiet beauty in these cold, scarred spheres, so immensely far away from the warm embrace of their star. It's time to move on. Your computer tells you that the space here is emptier than before, and that can only mean one thing. The first big planet in the system is coming up. You already know that this star system has four big gassy planets in the outer regions and then four small rocky ones in the inner region. And you think about how different that is from your home. Who would have guessed a system like this could exist? You feel yourself get more excited, but also somewhat impatient as time passes. Where is this planet hiding? Aha! There it is. It's definitely much, much larger than all the other objects you've encountered so far. And as you get closer, you notice it has a companion as well. You suspect there will be more. Big planets tend to have a lot of secondary planets with them. This thought has barely formed, and your computer has already found several much smaller companions. It appears the planet has a thin, dark ring system as well. This is truly amazing, and you are reminded that this is why you love your job. Any new star system is always full of surprises. Your ship passes by, and so you turn around again so you can enjoy this as much as you can. Now you see the planet and its companions fully illuminated by their star. What a sight to behold. Various shades of deep blue and wisps of bright white dance and dance on the surface. Those white trails look like they sit high in the planet's turbulent atmosphere. Those darker spots must be massive storm systems. Your attention shifts to the planet's largest companion, a peculiar greenish-gray orb, its surface unexpectedly devoid of impact craters. According to a scan your computer just ran, there is cryovolcanic activity here, which could explain the diverse and relatively smooth terrain. Fascinated, you wish you could spend more time studying this planet, but your mission's final goal is not here, and there's still a long journey ahead, and so you mentally bid your farewells to this marvelous blue marble. Your ship steadily makes its way deeper into the system, and your anticipation grows. What is the next planet going to be like? A sound from your computer alerts you, and you watch the crescent shape draw closer. This planet appears to be very similar in size and composition to the blue one, mostly various gases and a rocky core. You fly past, turn around, and there it is in all its glory. A featureless, magnificent pearl of the palest green, serenely floating in the blackness. And it has at least four small companions, all frozen bodies made up of rock and ice. Your computer pings. It has found another small companion, and a dark, faint ring system. You're only half paying attention, still in awe of the beauty you see before you. You've only explored the first planets of the star system, and you're already wondering if it will get any better than what you've already seen. But you suspect it will, and so you turn around again, onto the next world. You were right. As your ship approaches, you can immediately see that this planet is truly something amazing. It's larger than any of the planets you've seen so far, and it has an absolutely huge, bright ring system, probably one of the biggest ones you've seen in your entire career. You decide to take control of the ship for a bit and get a closer look. You wonder what could have caused these rings to form. Generally, a ring system forms around a planet when one or more small companions orbit too close and break apart due to the gravitational forces becoming too strong. In this case, it may have been a bigger companion planet. Either way, these rings make for a spectacular crown for this sand-colored giant. Now, your computer is picking up several companions, and most of them are cold orbs of mostly ice and rock. The biggest one stands out to you, however. It appears to have a thick atmosphere that completely conceals the surface from view. A scan shows there is surface liquid here, which may be a sign of potential life forms, but you're not here to investigate this planet companion. You wonder what secrets may be hiding there. What a pity you don't have more time, a bigger ship, and a team of fellow researchers with you. You make another maneuver so you can get a good look of the planet from above. The gaps in the rings seem to be caused by small asteroids, and their orbits appear to be shaping the rings. How interesting. You suddenly realize you're paying so much attention to the rings that you almost missed how beautiful the planet itself is. Shades of brown swirl in fine bands across the surface, dotted with many small storm systems. You notice the enormous, somewhat hexagon-shaped storm at the planet's pole, and its oddly greenish-blue colors. Your computer pings again, letting you know you still have work to do. And as much as you wish you could stay and stare endlessly at the marvel before you, it's time to get going. What else will the system have in store? Now, the biggest planet is up ahead. You can see the crescent of this massive ball of gas glowing in the distance. Already, your computer picks up three companion planets. The ultra-zoom camera is providing you with close-up images. Now it's time to turn your ship to get a better look at what appear to be bands of gas in the planet's atmosphere. This goes above and beyond your expectations. Rusty orange hues, milky whites, soft grays, muted browns, and dusty greens swirl in an eternal dance. It's almost surreal, as if you're looking at something born from a talented artist's vivid imagination. You maneuver your ship again, so you can have full view of this magnificent planet. There's another companion, and this is a particularly interesting one, since it's bright yellow. You vaguely wonder what the cause of that coloration is, while taking in the absolutely breathtaking beauty of this crown jewel of the star system. That flaming red storm looks like it's big enough it could swallow an entire planet. Come to think of it, this is one gigantic storm caught in a sphere by the forces of gravity. as if these forces have a mind of their own and simply wish to create a piece of art. You've been ignoring your computer's signals for a little while now, and it pains you to leave. You could stare at this wonder of the cosmos for ages. It's time to say goodbye to the gas giants and venture deeper and discover what secrets the small rocky planets hold. Hang on, it seems that space here is getting a bit crowded. You've flown into an asteroid field. This is no reason to worry at all, since the field is still mostly empty, just less empty than the rest of space. Oh, there's a small planet here. It's really tiny though, and you suspect it may be a primordial leftover of when the major planets here were formed. What a stark contrast after just visiting the king of the planets of this system. You leave the asteroid field, and there you can see the next planet. It's significantly bigger than the primordial planet you just saw, but it's still quite small. It's rusty red in color. It has two tiny asteroid companions. You get close enough so you can make out details on the surface. It's full of ancient scars and impact craters, and there is a canyon so huge it's clearly visible even from the distance you're at. This red planet has volcanoes, and the biggest one is so large its peak sticks out through the wispy clouds. The clouds are interesting for sure, since they clearly prove there is an atmosphere here, although it's thin. And of course clouds mean moisture, but a scan shows the only water here is in ice captured at the planet's poles. What a pity. So close to its star, with an atmosphere and water on the surface, this planet may once have been a potential home. But warmth and flowing water are fleeting and rare in the cold depths of the universe. You wonder if life ever had a chance here, but there wouldn't be much going on right now, and so you move on. Now your journey will first take you past the star before you can visit the remaining planets. And there you go! Oh, your computer already detected another planet. This one is very small as well, and orbits its star fast and close. If there ever was enough gas here to form an atmosphere, it's long been blown away by stellar winds. The surface is heavily scarred and cratered, and likely ancient. The planet's day side is scorchingly hot, but its night side is extremely cold. Against all odds, small pockets of water ice sit in the eternal shadows of the craters at the poles, where the star's searing light can't reach it. One might not expect this on a world so small and barren. You've been so involved with the observations that for a little while, you forgot that the best part of the journey still lies ahead. There is one more stop on your way to your final destination. As you approach this planet, the biggest of the rocky planets you've seen so far, you're somewhat reminded of the pale green gas giant you saw before. The surface is completely shrouded in opaque clouds, and so it appears smooth and almost featureless. You get a higher contrast image of the planet, but of course this doesn't reveal the true face of this field world. Scans show that the surface temperature is much higher than can be explained by heating from the star. The intense heat must be trapped by the thick layers of clouds. Nothing could live down there. You almost feel a bit offended. This is a perfectly nice rocky planet in a perfectly nice orbit around a smaller star, and yet all it seems to be is a highly toxic hellscape. If given all the right chances at the right times, it doesn't take much for life to bloom, but things can go wrong so quickly. You wonder how much was lost to the frozen depths of space and time without any awareness of being, without stargazing and dreaming, without even a whimper or a sigh. So many promises, like dust in stellar winds, while galaxies ever drift, only to eventually lose each other, and the final remains of that first burst of light slowly die. But not yet. You are here because something happened here long ago that is nothing short of miraculous. You are here because sometimes the universe is not so unforgiving, and everything works out just right. And instead of frozen wastes or violent storms or ancient and dead rock, there is a 1 in a billion chance of light and energy converging into something truly beautiful. There it is, small, so brightly white and intense blue that it's almost like it's mocking the dark depths surrounding it. Its companion is huge in comparison, a pale gray orb glowing in the starlight. Time to get a better look. You don't need your computer scans to tell you what is clear as day when you look at this planet. This is a breathing, living world. The deep blue of the water, the playful browns and vivid greens of the land, the swirling clouds. It looks completely different from your home, and yet you feel a sense of kinship with the beings that exist down there. They too were born from the dust of dying stars, even if there is no creature here that might realize this yet. Or are there? The computer is telling you all sorts of things, but you decide to see for yourself. The planet's night side, it's full of lights. This is almost too good to be true. You have traveled so far, all alone for so long, to find the ultimate treasure. Other people. Protocol prohibits you from getting any closer to investigate. You are just an explorer and observer. There is so much you wish you could find out right now. What do these people look like? What are they made of? How do they move, see, and think? How do they communicate? How do they build things? Do they also search the cosmos for others? You can't have your answers right now, but it doesn't matter. This first visit is coming to an end and you will embark on the long trip back home. But you're going to return and you won't be alone. Don't go anywhere, you think. I'll be back soon.